between these two teams, players who played together, split ways, drama, etc. There's even a full documentary about it.
Oh, top lane, don't miss it.
Don't worry. Wouldn't dream of it. Another Baron Strike coming in a second. First blood. No, he hasn't got the damage. It's S4 and Crit who get the kill. They will get the revenge one on Jerex, but
Crit with another stun. That's a dead Grimstroke.
One or two more right clicks. He's got the early point in the Fiery Souls for the attack speed, and he finds the double kill on Crit's Lina.
1,000 gold on Lina.
Yep. Playing Sand King, say level 6. Not going for the Epicenter, so similar to the Tide, but Tide is holding a skill point, so if he wants to skill that Ravage, he can. And just rotate in. Going for that early Slider Fist. Doesn't have any points in the Searing Chains, but level 4 Slider Fist does a lot of damage. Jerex in some trouble as he gets stunned up. The cooldown follow-up is there, and this should be a kill, but if OG can cut it just to one loss...
Yep.
That damage from the coming out from the duo, more than enough to get the kill here. Now they're rotating in mid. Thompson has to be a little bit careful here. Does have that 4 points in Slider Fist with the Fire Remnants to get out of there. It's going to be another cooldown from Arteezy. He's looking for No Tail. Definitely looking like a dead Chen here. Doesn't have level 6, no Hand of God, but the Sand King shows up from the side, has got the Epicenter fall for Burrow Strike. He defensively Astral's to keep himself alive. Fly gonna take all of that damage here as Seb comes back looking for the OD. He's gonna die, but he, in the process, gets the kill for Jerex. Use that to actually try and gank him just yet.
They're just giving him the mean look.
Yeah. Rotation's coming in, a CS4 Thompson. He's hit level 8 now, still not going for the Searing Chains, wants to prioritize the more defensive build. See, he's going to Remnant on forward, has got the Inkswell on now. This is not looking good for Fly. The cooldown being used as well. Thompson, Slider Fist is there with the Burrow Strike follow-up. They may get S4 as well. He's been silenced up now as well. Has got the Ravage. If he can get rid of the silence, he's not going to get a chance to go for it, though. Not sure it would have mattered too much as well, as Arteezy wasn't really in fighting shape there. But at the same time, EG. Talk about OG reading EG's movements, it goes both ways. They dire scan, they see this movement coming. Will they try and bait and take this fight? They need the Tide, the Ravage is coming. It's not quite here in time, perhaps. Arteezy's gonna be careful, he's gonna go down. He does not have a BKB yet. Tide's rotated in from the side, but they're gonna throw at the Ravage, hit several, they kill off No-Tail. He instantly buys back to come back into this fight. No-Tail will be TPing back in as Thompson in the front lines with that Flame Gun. He's just so damn tanky, and the Slider Fist spam does so much damage at this stage of the game. They're going to look for a fourth kill here. They want S4, and there's just nothing EG can do to win this one. Another Burrow Strike from Seb, and they're going to finish off S4 as
and
well.
Sumail bails them. He just TP stopped to pick up at least the Bounty Runes because this fight didn't go well.
He's in
already
trouble,
used the Blink Dagger and Azrael. He's dead.
Yeah. He may have gotten a Bounty Rune, but he's getting some tips. OG, 4k gold lead, they just completely team wiped EG. They killed every single hero in the game.
Bottom lane.
They will lose Jerex. He gets caught, left behind, but ultimately that is a support. Mr. Smokebreaker himself.
Oh, he only has a recipe. Gyrocopter getting closer, 600 gold away from it. The timing from OG is insanely good. BKB is up on Alchemist. They want to make something happen.
Yeah,
right,
they
now
blink in with the stun, the Burrow Strike. They want to burst down Fly here. It is just an Ogre Magi, but in the back lines, they're going to throw out a Ravage here, trying to turn this one around here. But Thompson was inside the Astral, so he doesn't get hit by this. Ogre going to buy back, going to try to take this fight, but Thompson's just charging it forward. He Remnants in aggressively, using the Slider Fist, constantly just nuking everyone
Seb's
down.
Gonna go in.
Epicenter with the blink in as well. Who's he going for? He splits the targets. Anna with the BKB takes out the Lina, changes targets. Going to be a dieback from Fly's Ogre. He goes down, and Seb's not done with S4. That's four dead. Seb gets tipped by his teammate as OG roll over EG. Four heroes dead.
That's actually five dead because Ogre
yep.
bought back and died instantly.
Crit gets out of there. Managed to maneuver his way through the trees getting out of there, but Arteezy not so lucky. He goes down top. That was with the BKB. Seb, Epicenter, Burrow Strike, completed Pipe of Insight.
It's looking all OG. Actually, it's 17,000 net worth for them.
At 21 minutes too. OG are playing such good Dota right now.
Oh, you can quote me on this one. The game is over when you have 1,000 gold lead per minute.
Yeah, well, they're not there yet. They have a bit more to go. Just going to stand here and hit some buildings. The Slider Fist spam is just zoning them away.
Rocket.
Arteezy may have a BKB, but he's already half health. He doesn't want to fight. With the constant chip damage coming out from Slider Fist, from the Stroke of Fate, from the Grimstroke, those long-range AoE nukes may want to go for as well. A Tier 1 and a Tier 2. Arteezy playing a bit greedy, going for another creep wave. He may just have to BKB TP out. He gets caught by an unstable concoction. Burrow Strike follow up, and Arteezy is done for. And it's Dota Plus 99%.
EG.
This, it's not
what
bugged.
Is the 1%?
Yesterday
yeah,
we
yeah.
had some bugs with 100%. Oh,
yeah. Well, there's 1% for EG, and they're gonna have to dig deep to figure out where that 1% is. It is looking mighty difficult. They go and out, and he can't get the BKB off in time. He's getting chainsawed. This is the 1%. They take out the Alchemist. They start the fight off with a great kill on Alk, and they are going to repel OG here. Aegis expires as well. EG have picked their timing perfectly as the BKB gyrocopter goes charging in. They're going to take out the Sanctum.
Sentry while smoke. Not what you want to do, maybe.
Ember Spirit just scouting things out with Arcane Rune and Ags.
Oh, that's so cheeky. And now Thompson, he's maybe going to look to pick off Fly here. They throw him with the Blink Ravage. Can they actually bring down the Ember Spirit? He's getting bursted here with the Chant Heals. Is it going to be enough? They take out Thompson. Instantly buys back. But Arteezy's already in with the Flat Cannon, the BKB. He's going to delete the Sand King. Buybacks from OG. They want to take this fight. And with Anna's BKB on Alchemist, they should be able to have this one. Anna, can he stun off Arteezy? He jukes into the trees. Finds a new target. Can he blink out of this one? He gets Burrow Strike. The timing from Seb is perfect as OG. They had to commit a couple of buybacks, but they do come out on top. And with Ravage down, with BKB Gyro down, I imagine they feel like they can actually break the high ground here.
Look at the Ember Spirit.
He's just gone balling in. Seb follows up. Two-man Burrow Strike. Arteezy's got no BKB to defend himself. Two mail. He's bought back. He uses defensive Astral, but I don't imagine Arteezy's got much of an escape. As soon as he comes out, he's popped like a pinata. Instantly has to buy back. But Anna,
Gyro should be
back off.
I mean, Alchemist should be careful.
Just trying to see what they can force out here. But back in the mid lane, Alchemist, he's gone in with a big blink BKB. He's going on crit here. The right clicks with the BKB is going to be enough. And now Arteezy in trouble. He's been Abyssal Bladed up. He's locked in place. Where's the Bashes, says Anna. He doesn't quite find it. The Ravage is there. And Anna, he's got no buyback. He's going to be so careful not to go down here. But he's got so much health regen from the Chemical Raid. Sumail's wailing away on him. The right clicks. Is the Eclipse going to be enough? He doesn't have the damage. The cheese is there. And now Sumail getting bashed up. Stuns followed up. And GG, EG, drop game one of this two-game series.
OG, they Dominant. Played so well.
This is a scary looking OG draft. With not to say there's anything wrong with EGs. You look at EGs and like Sven Bane, like this, they've got answers to the jug with the Bane. They've got a strong lane with this Dark Willow Abaddon, at least we think they do. Brambles coming out to try and mess with some of the last hits and secure this lane a bit. But here comes Jarex with these crits. If he gets the block in, he blocks his forward, doesn't hit him with the stun, but he's completely surrounded. Now he levels up the spin. They are looking for this kill, but Jarex hanging very low. The Stroke of Fate is there, and Anna should be able to get the first blood. Gets the kill just before No-Tail goes down. That's a shared bounty. We'll see a full-on tri-lane from OG. Thompson, is he going to get killed here by Sumail? The decrypt is there. With a Nether Blast, one or two more right clicks. Thompson has a Tango. He tried to go for the tree block. Oh, that would have been so good if it worked. EG, 2k gold lead already. This landing stage has been very favorable for them with the kills they're getting, with the farm they're securing. Sven, Arteezy absolutely free farming. But they've got to be careful. Here comes Anna again in this bottom lane. He's got the Inkswell stun, and one or two more right clicks might be enough, but the stun immediately dispelled off by the Aphotic Shield, but the Blade Fury allowing him to chase through the Shadow Realm, and the damage from the magic is enough. Anna gets a healing ward in the trees here, so he's healing up, but he's completely trapped and surrounded. He's trying to turn and fight. The healing ward, not enough there, just level one. And now No-Tail, he needs to be careful himself.
No-Tail is dead. Yep. The Furred Shaker doesn't have a Fissure. He does.
Got a totem followed up by a Fissure. They are looking to turn this one. No-Tail with the Inkswell stun. He's got one kill. He's getting a second. This healing ward is causing all kinds of problems. The Stroke of Fate
Whoa.
As well.
Abaddon.
No-Tail with a double kill.
Abaddon had the Aphotic Shield ready. Bane is just guarding it. He can easily gank the side lane.
Uh-oh. No-Tail. This is not a lane you want to really be in at this point if you're OG, but that's why they send their 5 position down there.
Yeah,
No-Tail,
that's going to be a free tier 1 tower on the bottom lane.
Looks like Arteezy is looking to come in from behind. They're just going to go diving for this kill. Slide a fist to start with some damage to the Fissure. We'll catch them out a little bit here. Remnant on forward. Arteezy's got the stun, and this should be a dead No-Tail. He goes for one last Stroke of Fate, but won't get a chance to...
You can see what kind of game OG is playing right now. Well, can you? I mean, they don't have a single observer ward over the river.
They've gone in on No-Tail here with the grip here. No-Tail is staying alive here. The RP comes just to cancel that grip, although it was about to wear off. Sumail's going to be a little bit careful. Gets caught by the Inkswell stun. Is he going to go for this kill? Has a sleight of fist. Cancels the salve. Sumail isn't going to commit for the kill. Jarek's making a fairly bold move into this enemy jungle. Just trying to scout out some of these stacks to see what's going on. Sven's turning this on with the stun, though. Have they got any follow-up lockdown? Doesn't look like it. The Bane not quite here, at least not right now. Jerk's charging on forward, has the term. They're trying to bait out this borrowed time. Echo Slam comes in, doesn't do a whole lot of damage, barely clips Arteezy, and S4 borrowed times it off here as Arteezy does pop the Godstreak. Is he going to look to go in and fight the Skewer? Is there followed up by Nappy? But the fear, it stops the Omni Slash. That saves their lives here. They could still look to turn this one around. Anna goes in with the Healing Ward, but without the Omni Slash on the RP, crit saves the day. The Healing Ward gets sniped as well by Sumail. He does manage to dodge the stun from the Storm Bolt here as Anna goes charging forward here. The Blade Fury damage should be enough with the Omni Slash follow up. He doesn't even need the Omni Slash. He finds it now. He gets the double kill. Anna playing this fight so incredibly well in the back lines. He's been nightmared up though.
Sumail still chasing. Kill.
Looks like Anna's going to be back to safety as Sumail. Yeah, he's going to slide a fist down the Pugna. You know, scout
now,
your...
Oop, now he's inside.
Yeah.
But it's going to be too late.
Thompson. Fear. Heads himself out. They need to get that fear in soon. I believe they're going to be a little bit too late here. Can Crit get in on time? He's got a Blade Fury as well if he needs to use it. Anna's trying to get it low. There is going to be a Remnant into the pit. He comes in too late. Anna's already got it. Anna picked up the Aegis as well as the Roshan kill. And OG want to take this fight. Now they've got an Aegis. They take out the Dark World to start the fight. Arteezy comes in the backline, goes on the Pugna, but the problem is he's got no solution for the decrypt. There's no BKB. He's been RP'd now as well. The RP catches out a couple here. Anna charging forward. He's still got Omni Slash, but he doesn't want to commit that on Sumail, but he does once he's burned his mana. He knows there was no Fire Remnant out. He burned his mana with the Diffusal Blade. He's killed off three. S4 now in trouble. No borrowed time available. They're killing him one by one. Jerix tips S4. I think they know this Swede has no escape to the Diffusal Blade slow. S4 is going to be the fourth casualty. Arteezy got RP'd. He does survive, but that's because OG were focusing on the rest of the kills. See Anna take an uncontested tier 2 tower top. Sven doing what he can mid. He's got the Blink Dagger, so not the easiest tier to go find. Arteezy, it feels like the same problem as last game. A very different game overall, but it's this BKB timing of his that just comes a little bit too late. He needed it like for that fight there in order to take a team fight.
Either that or Abaddon needs to take care of him.
Yeah. And again, he can't really defend. He's gone in on the back lines here. He's looking for the Pugna. Can he finish him off? Thompson. He's got a decrypt to help him out. He's got the ward on the high ground as well as a life drain. He's got the double life drain as well with the soul bite. He's healing so much because of this. S4's borrowed time comes up, but Thompson's back to full health. And they've lost the Shaker though, but OG still want to take this fight with the Aegis in hand. Unfortunately for them, EG repositioned on the high ground. The two-man stun coming out with the Storm Hammer, and Arteezy's absolutely deleted Seven. The Aegis popping on Anna means he could be in trouble when he comes out of this one. There's no Fiend Script to deal with him. The Omni Slash is there. He's bouncing around. He's not actually going to get the bounce into the three heroes. He goes for the Blade Fury TP instead.
They're still chasing. Do they have it? Yes, yep. There's the Yule Scepter.
And EG, ultra kill for Arteezy. Well.
Soul Ring active called Sacrifice.
Okay.
Well, that makes a lot of sense.
Oh, smoking. Anna leading the way. Finds Fly. He's going to instantly delete him. As Arteezy jumps on the back lines, he gets the two-man stun, but the RP is there just to climb around. The Omni Slash is going to go on through doing some good damage here. Fear looking for the back lines. Will catch out a couple. Actually catches out Anna as the Omni Slash wears off. But Arteezy is so incredibly low, looking for a blink out, I imagine. Or even a blink back in. Thompson, he gets killed off by Arteezy's Stormhammer. Jug. Looking for gun down crit here. Anna needs a couple more right clicks, but he's being gripped up now. Skewer is there, cancels the Fiend Script. Nicely played by Magnus, keeping him alive. As that's going to force out a Remnant just to escape here. Seb charging on forward. They should be able to at least finish off the Bane here. And Jerix knows that's a dead Bane. He's looking for more. He blinks past, but there's no fresh targets to go for. But this Roche fight is going to be so hotly contested. Fighting around Roshan, this is where buybacks really come into play. And Pugna. Buyback on cooldown means Thompson has to play this Roche fight incredibly cautiously. Oh, Sumail's just gonna go remnanting in. They get the two-man roots. Is there a fear to follow it up? You betcha. Catches out two. Jerix is in trouble. He's been taken out by Arteezy. Instantly buys back, but they've also lost No-Tail, who does not have a buyback. And Thompson, we talked about his buyback stats. He's dead for 75. This could be EG securing themselves Roshan. Anna's been slept up. Is there a Fiend Script? It's on cooldown. It's already been used. Anna's got the Blade Fury.
Anna still has ulti.
Yeah,
he's Ember Spirit's out of the Remnants.
Yeah, they throw out the RP. There's going to be a nightmare to try and save him. Sumail's out of mana. Sumail's dead, and they're going to lose Sven as well. Anna with a double kill for his team. Only got the one kill. Godlike streak on Arteezy is ended as S4 does not have borrowed time, and the Blade Fury is just going to look to chase him down. Jerix with the stuns. His buyback coming into play there.
They should go straight into Roche Pit. They still have a healing ward.
You've got
space.
To burst
this
him
Lotus
now.
Orb is doing God's work because Sven can't really throw
he's
a
out
stun.
Of mana. Sven, he's down to 150 mana. He can't actually take this fight, even if they don't kill him. Arteezy's forced back to Fountain, so I think OG may try and take this Rax. The problem is no one can really wake him up. If Magnus wakes him up, he probably dies for it. So you let Anna take the Rax here. He's got Blade Fury if you want to use it now, but Seb hiding in the trees. He gets the RP on the back line. This Cura in forward. They're going to throw out an Omni Slash. Arteezy does get the BKB up, but he's dying in the Omni Slash. Arteezy's been bashed up as well. It's a dieback. He's beyond godlike. Anna absolutely destroys them on the back line. Sumail, he's trying to do what he can. He's gone in. One versus three. He's lost his Willow. That's a dieback from Crit as well. And Sumail is in all sorts of trouble. EG running out of lives. They're just all dead. They're so bound up. Two of them linked together. The Cura are going to push them as well. And it looks like EG, they're down to their last lives here. They buy back on the Ember Spirit. S4 gets taken out as well. He's got no buyback. Jerix is invis in the backline with the Shadow Blade. He stuns up Sumail once, gets the second stun as well. That's an instant dieback from him, and I think this is GG. EG have been 2-0'd by their nemesis. OG take them out once again. It's a bit of deja vu from the last time these two teams met at TI.